Good afternoon, everyone, respected panel members, and my dear student managers. I, Harshita Rathod.
And I, Ekta Yadav from River Narmada.
We are here to give the presentation on topic case study. Case study on Glaxosmithkline in the context of Indian market. Next.
These are the contents that we will be discussing further.
Next. Okay, so GSK started its journey in 1924 in India to become one of the leader in the pharmaceutical industry, and it is a global healthcare company with the purpose to help people to do more and feel better and to live longer. And it established in 2000, and with the merger between Glaxo, Wellcome and Smithkline, and it is a British multinational pharmaceutical company, and it has headquarter in Brentford, London, and in India it has headquarter in Worli, Mumbai. Mr. Annaswamy Vaidesh, who is the Vice President of GSK in South Asia and Managing Director of GSK in India. And the focus areas of GSK are pharmaceuticals, vaccines, consumer healthcare products. It has presence in almost 117 countries. Next, please.
Now let's go through the products. Mainly they are divided into two categories, pharmaceuticals and consumer healthcare. Pharmaceuticals have two parts, medicines and vaccines. Medicines and vaccine. Vaccines I have like hepatitis B and cancer vaccines also are available. Then consumer healthcare, they have Boost and Horlicks are leading in the market of consumer healthcare. Then right, there please. Are other food categories like foodles and other biscuits. Then for the digestive management, they have provided Eno. For pain management, they have Iodex. And respiratory, Clocin and Otrivin. And for oral care, Sensodyne. So, Otrivin, all these products have also have subsidiaries. Like Otrivin have divided into adults and for kids and for the people who require less amount of respiratory problems.
Next, please. Next. So these are some competitors of GSK Pharma. The first one is Sun Pharma, and the second is Lupin. The third one is Sanofi India. Now talking about the Glaxosmithkline, and it has market capitalization of rupees 20,789.51 crore, and it has sales turnover worth rupees 3,128.53 crore, and it has net profit worth rupees 425.36 crore. Next, please.
These are the competitors for consumer healthcare, Nestle, Britannia and Varun Beverages. Here, the sales turnover of Glaxosmithkline, the sales turnover is 4,782.01 crores and the net profit is 982.80 crores.
Next please. Okay, now continuing with the topic, these are the sales and marketing practice, and these are the marketing strategy of GSK. So the first one is support education for doctors. So GSK support education for the doctors, and in terms of funding, and they tie up with the third party, that is independent medical organization, and they give authority to the medical organization to decide the education program for the doctors without influencing GSK from GSK. And the second one is using digital channels instead of healthcare professionals. So they don't speak with the physically healthcare professional to sell their products. They use digital channel with the real time on applications and where the expert of medicals. Talk about the answers and questions of the about the medicines of GSK. Next, please.
So this is the recent merger which the first negotiation started in December 2018. HUL is going to acquire GSK Consumer Healthcare in India. It's the all equity merger, and the valuation of the total business is 31,700 crores. So what HUL will gain from this? First, it will give additional to the 4,200 crore to their total revenue. And second, as GSK has the networking of 800 plus distributors and 8 lakh plus retail outlets, so it will be helpful for HUL products to provide it all over India. Second, GSK consumer gains. Here, the HUL has the 8.2 million outlets that will help the Horlicks to expand its business and provide it in all these outlets. Second, it will also help in HUL will upgrade, premiumize, and unlock the north and west region of India.
Next, please.
And this is the second joint venture which also happened in 2018-19. The CCI, Competition Commission of India, has approved GSK and PFizer joint venture in consumer healthcare. Sorry, it is in pharmaceuticals. So GSK's equity interest will be 68%, which will give them the majority of shares. Second, PFizer equity share interest will be 32%. And the reason behind is this, that it will strengthen its pharmaceutical business over the next few years. These both companies are from UK, so it will help them build their business more and provide more pharmaceutical facilities and also help them in their research and development in India. Second is, that's here, and to create substantial value for shareholders. Maybe they will not be able to provide maximum amount of dividend, but they will be able to provide their shareholders subsequent amount of value for their shares.
Okay, coming to the corporate social responsibilities, the first one is support the Skill India. So GSK are supporting the Skill India initiatives, so and they are making efforts to generate the employment opportunities for the people. The second one is aligned with the Swachh Bharat Swachh Vidyalaya campaign. So GSK is aligned with the aligned with the Swachh Bharat campaign to ensure access of water hygiene facility in each and every school. The third one is efforts towards child nutrition. So they are making the efforts towards the child nutrition, and the main aim of GSK is to improve the child nutritional status of women, married women, and small children. Next, please. So here is the conclusion. GSK highlighted the prioritization of R&D and new product launches as its key growth drivers in 2018 and 2019. Second is GSK recently launched products, Singrix vaccine for the prevention of shingles in adults 50 years or older, and respiratory products such as Trelegy and Nicola. Thank you.
Next one. These are the sources from where we get the data: moneycontrol.com, indiaconsumer.gsk.com, indiapharma.gsk.com, and GSK Annual Report 2018-19. Thank you.
Thank you.